Hey guys, say hello.
Hello.
We're doing a nighttime walkthrough.
Hi.
Hey.
So, what are you all working on? Come on, what are your names?
Map.
Okay.
This is like the game that we're thinking of. You start off from here.
Okay.
You need to go till here.
Okay.
But the only twist is the map can't be navigated with, you know, your actual phone. You need to move around to navigate the map.
So it's sort of a
real world maze solver.
What if the roads don't match your map?
Oh no. So there's no actual road. It's just a built-up map. So you imagine that there's, you know, you're on a field and you imagine that there's a map actually built up there.
Right. But you need to be in a field, or you're talking about very small movement range.
We will talk about a small hop. So it can be played not in this room without a table.
Hmm.
Technically, so you just jump and we'll take the accelerometer chains for the jump and, you know, do something.
Alright. Okay.
So you just showed me some music app idea that they have, just checking it out.
Well, the only problem that we're feeling in this was that the media player element by default doesn't have very good memory management stuff.
Absolutely.
It can't play stuff together.
Correct.
So well.
Right.
So one of the guys helped us out and he told us sound pool is there, which you could use on.
So what we are doing is, me and Anurag, we are building an app where people can go and go to Landmark or say Crossword, take a book, scan it with our app and can see the price online, Flipkart, Reddit Books and all, Infibeam.
Okay.
So because the current pricing in the Landmark and Crosswords is very high, they'll give the books at the print price. But the same book can be bought from Flipkart or any other website at 20 to 50% discount.
Hmm.
So by this they can save and they don't need any effort. They just took out the app. On the app, this will be a scanner, barcode scanner.
Alright.
Scan it.
Scan the book's barcode.
And it will automatically do. They don't need to do any effort at all.
And you have a buy button.
Yeah, we have a buy button.
So how about a queue button? Because a lot of sites don't allow you to do one-click purchases.
Correct.
So what you should do is probably a queue button and say, go back and see this at home, a list of items to be scanned.
So, they have probably watch list, something like that.
Yeah, sort of a...
They can go to the website directly and can put it in the cart and can buy it.
Right, no,
what
I'm saying
is
that when you're standing there, it's kind of inconvenient to stand there and type in your credit card details.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's
nice. So, imagine just put in a queue,
go
out your computer.
You can go and do the QR code and then later on you...
Yeah.
We can then have an our own link which says that okay. Then.
You put an ad on it, put an affiliate link.
Thanks a lot.
How about you guys?
Hi.
Hi.
Let's talk about your project.
Hi, we are doing OpenGL related things.
Okay.
I am going to build one 3D cube having. So I built the OpenGL 3D rotating cube with all the Droidcon ball and Android logo. Rotating cube with OpenGL.
Spinning cube.
So, do you have something to show?
Yeah.
As of now.
That with some errors.
That's just a wallpaper.
Yeah. Unlike this kind of 3D stuff. We are planning to texture map these logos, Android logos, Droidcon logos.
The Borg and Droidcon logos on multiple faces.
And keep on rotating.
Okay, so this is building a 3D hack.
Yeah.
Alright. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
What are you working on?
Just reading about USB ports.
USB ports. Okay. So, give me a name and a little bit more on what you're doing.
My name is Anupam. Right now I'm reading about USB port, how mini and micro USB ports are interconnected and how which one is deprecated and why they were deprecated. And now if somebody want to use something as a phone charger on the go, how it can be developed and how it should be work to connect it with the new micro USB chargers.
Okay. So you're actually doing hardware stuff. You're reading up on how the hardware works.
See, it's all about hardware, but actually, is it possible to charge using a active USB device to as a charger for your mobile phone
if it's other than laptops, how it can be used without using any hardware changes, just with programming. Is it possible or not? So I was just reviewing that data on the net, if it's possible or not.
Alright, thanks for that. So are you building a hack by morning?
Actually my colleague is working on it.
Okay.
And he's trying to do it.
Alright, good luck. Is anyone here tonight? Hey Badri,
hey. Hi.
Who's the guy over there?
I don't know.
Missing? What's he doing? Creating bar charts with JFree chart. Okay, but the guy's missing in action. Let's go upstairs. Okay, just introduce yourself and your project.
Myself, Ashutosh Marula from Silicon MSS. And my project is a fitness flicker. In this, we use the pedometer and history of how to how many calories you burn, progress graph, and calculate the BP, calculate the weights.
Okay, so is it working yet? Or you built something?
Just here. Calculate steps. Meters.
Just put it down. Oh, okay, so you have to move it and it shows you.
And then it show the history.
Okay. All right. Oh, this is the kitchen. Nobody working on it, anything yet here? Let's see. Zero Red Bulls consumed. I guess the night is still young. Hello people. Intro.
I am Pratul and I'm working on a weird sort of idea that I had about getting people, random people, to meet up together for coffee based on no user profiles, just location data, anonymous location data.
Hmm.
And that's it. Basically a social sort of a thing without actually social. Being
okay.
Social. Being physically social more than being profilely social.
Okay. And what you guys have done here is taken what, how many mattresses? 3 mattresses and made a couch out of it. Okay, interesting idea. Who's next? What are you working on? Introduce yourself and what you're doing.
Hey, I'm Aditya. Actually just got here and trying to figure out what everyone's working on and see where I can pitch in. So,
right.
See you in a little while. I'll tell you what I'm up to.
Okay, we'll do one more round in the night.
Yeah.
What's it?
Yeah.
What's your project?
My project is my team is doing at the game at the town. I have to join with them. So currently I'm bringing my development environment.
Okay.
For Android. So
you I just think downloading Eclipse.
Yeah, you're in Eclipse. So it's up now. Within another half hour I will join with them.
Hi. Introduce yourself and what you're doing.
I am Bhaskar. I am building a plotting library which can be used for pie charts and bar charts.
Mm-hmm.
So any app can invoke the my app and just use it for their pitching their graphs.
Okay. Are you the guy who was sitting downstairs?
What?
Were you sitting downstairs in the room? Someone there has a window open that says free Bhaskar bar chart. Okay. Wow, you guys have a nice setup. Okay guys, introduce yourself and your project and can you close the window and put off the AC for a while because it's too noisy otherwise. I think this one also. Okay, so introduce yourself and explain your project.
Okay, so hi, I'm Ganesh. So okay, I'm explaining the project now. Okay. I just need to explain the project, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So this is a project which helps us to share our URLs or maybe other data after some time. So with the with our mobile, we can connect to the Chrome and we can just share that URLs with the Chrome and we can just open it in the browser. So it's
you're doing the reverse of Chrome to phone.
Yes.
You're doing phone to Chrome.
Yes.
That's what it's called, Drive to Chrome.
Drive to Chrome. Okay.
Yes.
That's a nice name actually.
So
next.
What we are doing is we are sending, like, you can share any link on your phone and it will automatically open onto your Chrome browser.
Okay.
So we have created a Chrome extension and Android app, and there's a Node.js backend which basically does the linking part.
Okay.
That's it.
So all four of you on the same project?
Yeah, all four of us on the same.
Right, give me your names.
Yeah, Ganesh.
You Ganesh?
Ritesh.
Madhukar.
Rakesh. Okay. You guys have a nice private setup in here. Huh? Closed room, all by yourselves. Alright, guys, introduce yourself and your project.
Hi, I'm Shiv Kumar. We are working on song and lyrics.
Okay.
I'm Vincent Ranjan. Working on the same project, we are working on the song lyrics, basically to display the lyrics of the song as the song plays.
Okay, so you basically highlight the word in the song that's currently being played.
Okay,
so it's three of you working on it.
Four of us.
Okay,
so I myself is Shankar. I'm working on song and lyrics application. So yeah, that's it. It displays lyrics with the song.
Okay. And you are?
Hi, myself is Suraj. I'm fresh and I'm working on this song in Pizza.
It's nice. Four-person setup in there. Sorry, what are you doing?
Top secret.
Top secret?
I'm going to see a screener.
We have already announced the BLR Droid blog, but we kind of, we're not doing anything to actually get it up. We said it'll be coming soon. So we finally gave up on what we were doing before and we are moving it to Blogger so that we have everything on Google. So me and Soham are working on that now.
Hey Soham.
Hey guys.
Other than that, what are we doing? We're helping people around.
Okay, so you're the tech consultants.
We're making them believe that. That we are good consultants.
So far, we're under the impression.
Yeah.
Right. So, are you doing anything else today? Just helping people?
Yes, hopefully they do something or maybe to play, right?
So far the reality distortion field is working.
Okay. More people in here. Hey guys.
Hey.
Alright, so what are you guys up to? You're the indoor tagging guys. Are you? So, introduce yourself and your project. What are you working on?
Myself is Rohan and I am working on a game based on Rajinikanth.
Rajinikanth.
Actually, I already started working on it. I am extending it. So it's a GPS based game. So it will get our current location and place Rajinikanth over there. The villain will place the bombs near about to our locations. And we can move out the maps. It's a realistic map, Google map. So we can go to the map, we can defuse the bombs, and again the villain will play some bombs and we'll continue.
That sounds like fun.
Yeah.
So do you have something to show there? Or are you copying Rajnikanth pictures and putting Amitabh Bachchan?
No, I'm doing here masking. Yeah.
So you're putting Rajnikanth's photo on Amitabh Bachchan's body?
No, this is different app.
Okay. Alright, so what are you working on?
I'll show you output. Actually, this application is mainly used for event, some other places in visit in beautiful places. You don't know address of that location. You want to share that location with your friends.
Mm.
Anytime using camera, whenever you click on camera, you get images. It is common thing.
Okay.
But here you're getting address of that image, address of the place.
So you take a photo and it tells you the address of the place.
Yeah, address of the place. And also annotating the image. Like this.
Okay.
Click on this one. Preview. Sign. Wish. Whatever you share with you share with your friends also.
Okay.
In Gmail, using Gmail account.
Okay.
And also I am doing another one is masking.
Hmm.
Here, this application. Sometimes hanging my system.
That's okay.
In masking application using camera again. I'm showing here some heroes like Amitabh Bachchan, Shah Rukh Khan. You selecting Amitabh Bachchan. After you click on camera, you take some other one photo.
Okay.
You attach the Amitabh Bachchan photo of that.
Okay,
that
so you put this yourself with Amitabh Bachchan. Okay.
Like this. And also share with this photo, share with in Facebook and Gmail and everything.
Nice. Great way to fool people into who you are with.
Give me some more time, I'll show you the demo of Rajni World.
Sure. Time. We'll be doing one more video in the middle of the night. Alright guys.
Hello.
Introduce yourself and your project.
Yeah, I'm Ashwin.
Suresh.
Swaroop.
Alright.
Yeah, so we are working on a call blocker app. So we have some kind of blacklist contacts and we'll block their calls. So as of now we are working on that and we are planning to work on the next step, that is location alarm. So it's kind of you can set an alarm, you can set say that when I reach that location, when I'm in the vicinity of that location, alarm me, that kind of thing.
That's what Locale does, right?
Sorry?
Locale does that. There's an app called Locale which lets you do these kinds of things. You can also make it, say, make it to-do list that only shows up when you're nearby.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. It's got a features like that.
Okay, so, yeah, that might be there. So,
yeah, mostly the intent is typically you're traveling somewhere and you're near to the place and you set the location alarm and you go off to sleep.
Okay.
And there are instances where you miss out the stop and you go ahead of it. Exactly. Or you keep waiting for the place beforehand. So typically this sort of a case, this can be avoided completely. The location alarm.
So the actual idea pops up while I was traveling to my home. So
okay, you missed your stop and you slept.
No. So I was expecting that Indore will came around 4 a.m. So
okay.
I woke up at 3 and keep waiting for it and it won't come till 6. So
okay.
I have to be awake from 3 to 6. Yeah, so then at that point of time.
So typically both are need based. So we've been annoyed by the phone calls and we've had instances where we missed out on a stop. So we're catering to our own needs.
Right. Have you heard of this company called Idea Phone? They're a Bangalore based startup. I think they're 2 or 3 people.
Okay.
They built exactly this. A solution to give you an alarm when your stop is nearby.
Okay.
And they took an interesting approach. So basically it only works for trains. So what they do is they follow the train's live schedule online.
Okay.
And they'll give you a call. So instead of an SMS, they actually call your phone automatically. You know, computerized call to your phone some 15 minutes before your stop.
Okay.
So they did something like that. So what you're doing is using your phone's own ability to keep track.
Yeah, I'm using normal GPS.
Alright.
Yeah.
Bye. See you. Good luck with that. Next.
Thank you.
Hi. I'm Chandrakant and basically today I'm basically develop a puzzle just like this is a puzzle.
So you actually built something.
Okay. This name is Arivat because Arivat is invented the zero.
Okay.
So when you shake this then game is generated. So basically I use the accelerometer for that.
Okay.
And after that after that you will have to fill the all the grid by the zero. So you started from the left top corner and choose maximum number of which number is maximum connected to this, just like a 4. Then this is a 4, then how much number is connected to this, so there is a 2 number 0. So you can fill the number of moves, given number of moves, maybe 20 30. So right now I am writing an algo for that. Basically I am using the shortest path algo, minimax I am using the algo. After that
you actually bring in a lot of math into this.
Yes.
Okay.
After that you can send your scores on Facebook and with the help, and I use the camera also, you can take a snap and by the and snap and your score you can send the Facebook, maybe Twitter, anything. I will
do.
Nice. Good luck with that.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. So introduce yourself and your project.
Yeah, myself Prashant K. I'm doing the alphabetical game application. It's only for game application for kid to learn the alphabets from A to Z. It's in alphabetic order only. From if you click A, it should be coming A, and then if you click B, it will come B. Next it will be C. If you click D, it will not come. It will not show. And then I had a music files on the background. It will be I will show in detail in this.
Okay, so you already built the app, right?
Yeah, I completed that app.
Okay.
I'll show my
Let's
app.
Let's see your app.
This is my application. It is only meant for kid to learn the ABCD alphabetic. It's like if the kid clicks the A, it will blast and will shows the A. Correct A, and then it next it should be like B. If the clicks other than B, like L or other than that, it will not blast. It will come on I'll set the background of the color of the music, and then it will be in the order like B, and then like C. It will be like in the order from A to Z. Like that. If you click other than that, it will not burst. It will change the things from A to other color, like that it will be there. Only for learning the alphabets for kids.
Okay.
This is a game application.
It's brilliant.
Yeah.
Thanks for that.
Yeah, thank you.
So you're actually done with this. It's ready
yeah,
to...
Yeah, it's ready to...
Sweet. Okay. Okay, the last room. So this is a pretty large hack night. Lots of people in here today. Padri, what are you working on?
I'm working on some part of NFC to integrate with the Droidcon app.
Okay.
Let me see how it comes around.
Okay, so you're working on the official Droidcon app?
I'm trying to contribute to the same.
Alright.
This is also late.
Alright guys, you're the last two. Introduce yourself and your project. Dude, you need to show off your t-shirt. The man's here.
Okay. Glad you didn't say, dude, you need to take off your t-shirt.
So I am Ashish, he's my partner Gaurav, and both of us are here building an app. In one line is Evernote for your medical needs. So it'll be a little more advanced than Evernote. Okay, it'll not match Evernote Assist, but it's more customized form of it, where you take your medical prescription, a pick from your app, the app will be building. And then there are certain fields you need to fill, like your doctor's name and hospital name and all that. And then it will be saved on the back end where you can retrieve it later, or you can change the tags and all. So we'll be doing the web side of it as well. Gaurav would brief more about it. So over to Gaurav.
Okay. Hi, I'm Gaurav. So basically, it's what he said. It's really a way of tracking your health records. If every time you go to a doctor, you get these receipts, prescriptions, things like that. So now you can track it every time with your phone. And if the doctor ever asks you a question like, what antibiotic did I give you last time, you have it all handy and you don't need to carry that file with you. And some of the data, for instance, maybe your weight or maybe your cholesterol level or sugar levels, things like that, if we can extract that data, then over time you can draw trends and things like that, which doctors may be able to analyze. They may be able to use that data if they're analyzing some condition. So there's more value to this than just storing those images. The extracting that data can help some future stuff.
So that's you guys, you got an interesting way of doing a dual monitor setup.
He's just showing me his site.
So I'm going to come back again sometime in the middle of the night and see how you all progressed.
Sure. So by the way, any update on the food?
The food has been ordered. It's on the way.
Okay,
cool. Yeah. It's a large order. Like if you end up say 60 rotis will not be around. Let's put some more in. That sort of thing. So we don't know how long it'll take for those guys to make and bring them all here.
There's no problem. So just that we are too very hungry here.
It's coming. There's some drinks in the fridge if you want to take some. Yeah. Help yourself to whatever is there.
Okay.
Yeah.
We can check it out here.
Yeah.
Thanks.
So
chai chai le lo chai
part time ho sakta
bade man se dil se bana rahe the
chai
yaar isme kalak nahi aa raha wo pehle lag
so Vinish, what are you working on
team
right now I'm making the tea.
She's a tea coordinator.
I'm basically just looking that these two guys are making tea properly or not.
Sorry, repeat that again.
Yeah, I'm just making sure that these two guys are making tea properly or not.
Okay, you're the tea monitor.
Yeah.
It's head boy.
So you're working with Rasagi.
Yeah.
Alright.
What is the tea testing algorithm?
He's hopping and testing.
Bus. बस बन गया नहीं
हाँ वो बन गया
चलो चलो करें
हाँ बस अभी गिरेगा थोड़ा थोड़ा
यार ये कहाँ से पक्का गिरेगा गर्म तो बोलेगा
जी
गिरेगा रुक जाओ बोले लो कब ले लो
बड़ा
कब ले लो कब छोटा लो बड़ा वाला दबाओगे तो और गिरेगा
डोंट रिकॉर्ड ऑल दिस
छोटा
कभी हैकिंग भी हो बस हैकिंग के अलावा कुछ और वही होता है ना
छोटा लड़का उसमें डुबो अंदर उसको रख दो नीचे
अबे केस में किसको डुबो
अरे रुको रख दो नीचे
एक्चुअली वो सॉसपैन में है इस बड़े बोल
मिक्सर में फाइनली दिस इज मी एंड बाय
रखो नीचे